Welcome back to Fox 8 News at Noon. It is an uncomfortable but necessary conversation, one we all need to have ahead of time. What kind of long-term care do your loved ones prefer? Joining me now is Mark Stratta, Senior Financial Planner with Sarka Financial. How are you, Mark?
Good. Today.
Today, right? You got in safe. You had a little bit of a drive, right?
But
you
it was easy. Okay. It was easy now.
Oh, yeah. It's getting better. I was asking you that because I need to leave here and get home, but it should be clear now, right?
Clear. Roads are dry.
Okay. Good to hear. At least on the west side, for sure. All right. Let's talk about this. It seems like these assisted living and these different places are kind of popping up everywhere, huh?
They are. It's part of reflects our population. We have conversations all the time with people that begin to worry, how am I going to reallocate resources so we can take care of this? But sometimes it's not about them, it's about the parents, trying to get the parents resolved. So there's multiple generations that are trying to answer this question. And the fact of the matter is, there's only two sources of financial support for long-term care and that kind of help, and that's either your own money or an insurance company.
Okay.
The largest provider of nursing home care is Medicaid, which is great, except that most people won't qualify for it because you need to be a certain age, you have to have a limited amount of income, and if you're a single person in Ohio, you can only have $2,000 in assets. So that raises the question of then how to, a whole debate is how to qualify for Medicaid. That's not what we're here to talk about today. For people who have other options, they turn to an insurance company.
Okay.
Today, insurance companies are offering life insurance and annuities that have long-term care benefits. And then there are people who have retirement plans, for example, PERS, STRS, that have options through their retirement plans to pick up long-term care insurance. It still has to be an underwriting issue, but when do you start that conversation? Do you start it in your 40s when you're still educating your children?
Right.
Do you start it in your 50s when you're trying to take a break for yourself?
Right.
Do you wait till your 70s when it might be too late?
Oh,
and then what do you do about your parents?
Well, tell us, what do you do that? When are you supposed to bring this up? When, you know, when is a good time to start talking about it?
It's a difficult time. The average age of a person going into independent living is 75.
Okay.
Assisted living is 85.
Okay.
So, and while as a general rule, we're younger at 75 and 85 than we were a generation ago, nobody likes to have that conversation.
Right, of course.
They really don't. Where's the money going to come from? So it's, and one of the things we have to tell the parents is maybe you stop being Banco de Mom and Dad and take care of yourself and quit trying to support your adult children. Very difficult conversation, just very, very difficult.
Oh, I can only imagine. And let's talk about where that money is really coming from. Is it something that we can start saving for now ahead of time?
You can. There are programs today, for example, for people who have IRAs. We talk a lot about IRAs in this program. A lot of people don't like having to take money out of the IRA, even though they're supposed to. There are ways today to use IRA money to fund your long-term care. There are ways to do it where both spouses can be covered on one person's IRA and use what are otherwise idle assets, perhaps, to help cover the cost of nursing home, if they exist. The best part about some of these insurance companies is that if you never use the benefit, you get your money back.
Okay. Well, a very tough topic to talk about, but it's such an important one.
It is very important.
We thank you so much for
glad to be here,
bracing the cold to come down here today. It was good seeing you again.
Thank you.
Of course, appreciate it. And of course, if you have any financial questions or need more information on Zarka Financial Services, you can head to our website, fox8.com, click on CNN TV.